Hi there, this is Eric from Gridgy. Welcome to this CodeRage session. I will show you how you can create a simple FireMonkey control that blurs whatever is displayed behind it, as you can see on this slide. You see these kinds of controls a lot in iOS and macOS apps to blur toolbars and sidebars and more. They are increasingly common on Windows and Android as well. And of course, since this is FireMonkey, the control will work on all platforms. So let's take a look at the steps we need to do this. Fortunately, there are only a few. We are going to create a control derived from tcontrol and override its paint method. In there, we first paint the parent control, that is the background, to an off-screen bitmap. We then apply a GPU accelerated Gaussian blur effect to the bitmap and draw it to the canvas of the control. The next slide will show this more visually. It shows some screenshots from the demo app that accompanies this source code. In the sample, the blurred control is placed on top of a tap control, making the tap control the parent. So the first step involves drawing the tap control to an off-screen bitmap. Next, we copy the part we want to blur to another bitmap, then we apply the blur effect to this bitmap and finally draw the blurred bitmap to the control's canvas. However, there are some issues with this approach. First, we need to allocate two off-screen bitmaps. Depending on the screen size, these can consume quite a bit of memory, especially on high DPI and retina displays. Also, the larger the bitmap, the more time it takes to draw the parent control. Finally, rendering the blur effect can be somewhat expensive. Even though most of the work is performed on the GPU, that still doesn't mean that it is free. Fortunately, there is a simple solution for these issues. We just render everything at half the original resolution. Since we are going to apply a blur, the reduced resolution will be hardly noticeable. The next slide shows these slightly modified steps. As you can see, we render to an off-screen bitmap now that is half the original dimensions and not high DPI aware. This reduces memory requirements by a factor of 4 or more and speeds up the blur effect as well. So let's look at the code we need to accomplish this, which is surprisingly little. Our tblur behind control derives from tcontrol and just adds a blur amount property. We declare two off-screen bitmaps here. The first one will be used to paint the parent control to at half the resolution, and the second one contains the region of interest from the first one that will be blurred using this Gaussian blur effect. The main method we need to override is paint. Here we see the steps presented earlier. First, we paint the parent control to an off-screen bitmap. Then, we apply the blur effect to the region of interest. And finally, we draw the bitmap to the control's canvas. We use the bitmap rect as a source rectangle. And we set the target rectangle to the local rect of the control so it occupies the entire control. This will stretch the bitmap to the target canvas. So let's look at the steps needed to paint the parent control. First, we cast the parent to a tcontrol. This is safe here since we require that the blur control is placed inside another control. We don't support placing the blur control directly on the form. Next, we update the size of the off-screen bitmap to half the dimensions of the parent control. Finally, we use the parent's paint2 method to draw itself to the bitmap, again at half the original resolution. Normally, when painting a control, it will also paint its child controls. Since the blur control is a child control, it will try to paint the blur control again, which results in painting the parent again in an endless loop. To avoid this, we need to set Disable Paint to True. Now that we have the screenshot, we need to blur it. Since our screenshot is at half resolution, we need to set the size of the bitmap to half the size of the blur control. Next, we calculate the rectangle inside the screenshot that contains the area of interest. This is the location of the blur control inside the parent, again adjusted for half the resolution. The next step is to copy the area of interest from the screenshot to our bitmap to blur. Then we can finally apply the blur effect to that bitmap. The process effect method takes three parameters, but only the second one is used for this effect type. However, if we leave it at this, then you will notice that the blur effect has horizontal and vertical artifacts. Let me show you by running this. You can see the horizontal and vertical lines here. These are caused by the fact that the Gaussian blur effect is not a real Gaussian blur, but more of a combination of a Gaussian blur and a box blur, hence the box-like artifacts. A simple solution for this is to apply the blur a second time at a lower setting. So let me uncomment these two lines here. Here we blur a second time at 40% of the original blur amount. Note that this is not the most efficient way to do this. The first blur copies the bitmap to video memory, applies the blur, and then copies it back to system memory. Then the second blur repeats these steps again. It would be more efficient if the two intermediate copy steps could be avoided. You can do this by creating your own multi-stage filter effect, but that is outside the scope of this sample. Let me know if you are interested in a blog post or video about creating custom GPU accelerated filters. Okay, let's look at the result now. This looks much better. The blur control is very responsive. Changing the blur amount is instantaneous. You can even animate the control and check how it performs when it needs to blur every frame. That's all you need. You don't need much code to write a simple blur control. Of course, you can experiment with other filter effects as well, or apply a color tint. You are only limited by your own imagination and what's practical and useful. If you want to give the code a try, then you can get it from our GitHub account. We created a separate repository for this code rage. We also have a blog you may find interesting. You can find it at blog.gridgy.com. Finally, you can reach me at eric@gridgy.com. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching.